कौनेन श्रवणं कुर्या मीन्स पुनः पुनः श्रवणं कुर्या. द वेदा सेज वन हैज टू लर्न टू लिसन पुनः पुनः. यू हैव टू लर्न टू लिसन. दैट्स व्हाई द वर्ड वेदा इवन दो इट मीन्स विद टू नो. Veda means with to know, knowledge. The other word for the Veda is Shruti. Shruti means, please see, Shruyate Anena Iti Shruti. Shruti means just listening. So therefore, the other word for the Veda is listening. And listening, listen until you understand. Asakrit Upadesha. Until you understand, learn to listen. So listening is a very great art. All of us take listening for granted. But listening is a very great art. And if you learn music, you will see the importance of listening. If you are learning especially classical music, you will find that to simply get Saregama Pada Nisa, at least minimum, without Shruti, it will take 2 years. Just to get Saregama Pada Nisa without Shruti. With Shruti it will take at least 6 months to 8 months. Right? Because listening is a very great art. And this is one thing that we have taken for granted. And when you take listening for granted, you never refine the quality of listening. Whenever you take anything for granted, you take your husband for granted, you take your wife for granted, then you will find you will never validate them in its totality. You will never validate them in its fullness. Taking for granted is one of the greatest sickness in living, which makes you like a living dead person. And if you are a living dead person, it is more dangerous than a dead person. Because a dead person, there is a possibility for him to be born. But a living dead person, he is living at the same time dead. Please listen very carefully to what I am saying. Because here in these talks, all my talks, more than information given to you, I am working on transformation. Giving information is one level. Working on transformation is another level. And transformation happens when you learn to live life wisely. Live life intelligently. And if you see a lot of people who mess up their life, if they do not know how to live life intelligently, live life wisely. They may live life smartly, but not wisely. So many years of experience I've got, and when people come for counseling, come for solving their problems, I find all because they do not know how to live life wisely. And the Bhagavad Gita is the greatest text which tells you how to live life wisely when you are encountering even death. Look at the whole scenario. Right at the field of battlefield, which is the field of death, any moment death can happen. Still Krishna says, even at that point of time, you can live life wisely. And if you live life wisely, death comes dancing to a wise person. And if you don't live life wisely, dancing comes to you like a dead bee. A great poet said, for a wise person, death comes even dancing to a person. So therefore, at the battlefield, where death can happen any moment, Lord Krishna's Upadesha is given. It's highly symbolic. Why symbolic? Because death can happen any moment. We are right now in a battlefield. Isn't it? We are right now in a battlefield. Every lorry, especially in Hyderabad, looks like a Yama Avaduta. That's why the shape of Indian lorries are very beautiful. And Hyderabad traffic is extremely wonderful. If you are alive, purely God's grace. And therefore, Hyderabad people are very devotional because only by grace they are living. The way the traffic goes, you know. I always tell
Every lorry is a Yama Avaduta. Anytime it can knock you off. Any point there can be an earthquake. Any point an asteroid can fall. Any point somebody can plant a bomb. Any point somebody can be ostracized. So therefore tell me, are we living in a battlefield? Anytime that can happen. Anytime somebody can poison you. If you want to become famous, when you become famous, somebody else feels jealous and he may stab you behind. Your competitor may feel very jealous with you. Are you getting this? I'm trying to see the similarity in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, which death can happen any moment, and the battlefield we are living right now, there is no difference. A student, a guru, please listen to the story. If you understand the story, you will get enlightened right now. If you don't understand, God save you. A student, right, listens to many years Guru's Upadesha. He listens to many years of Guru's Upadesha. Right, and therefore more and more Upadesha, the Guru is becoming better, but the Shishya remains the same. More and more Upadesha. That's why all my books I have dedicated to my students, if you see, in my cover. Because my students, more than Bhagavad Gita, my students have brought me enlightenment. Because when they come with their problems, with their tensions, there is no problem at all, but there's a problem. So therefore, this guru has been giving Upadesha teaching. Alright? The student is not being enlightened. Listen very carefully. And when the student is not being enlightened, the guru says, go and meet a certain person in a town and he will complete the teaching. Go and meet. The guru recommends another guru. Go and meet a person and he will complete the teaching. So therefore with this address, the Shishya goes to the town, and he goes to the town, then he finds, it's supposed to be a true story. In the Indian mythology, it's a true story. Right, goes there, and this sadhu, this monk, this sannyasin was shocked to see, he thought he's going to an ashram, to another place. Instead of an ashram, he sees a huge palace. He says, what is this, my guru? From an ashram is sending me to a palace, and he is a sadhu, he is a monk, he is shishya. So anyway, he goes into the palace. When he goes to the palace, he was shocked, right, to see that who he is supposed to meet was King Janaka, which Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita quotes, Janakadayaha karmana eva hi samsiddhim astita Janakadayaha. Lord Krishna also quotes by saying, people have attained by action. People like Janaka, the king, have attained. So you don't have to take sannyasa to be attain nirvana and moksha. So Krishna quotes there, this person goes and sees a king there, Janaka. And what is Janaka doing? He is seated and the girls are dancing. Girls are dancing, people are seated, drinking whatever wine they are drinking. Janaka is sitting and enjoying the dancing. Now this sadhu, this student, who the guru has said, utterly confused, isn't it? He got utterly confused from an ashram going to a palace, and in the palace, who is the guru? Janaka. And Janaka is watching what? Girls dancing. And he is enjoying the dancing, and the Veda talks of renunciation, and here he is enjoying, he wonders what is happening. Janaka looks at this monk, and says, please come. Right? I know your guru has sent me. I know your guru has sent. And this man says, how do you know my guru has sent you? And to which Janaka says, whatever the guru has told, you have not understood. If I tell, what will you understand? Come. Whatever your guru has told has not understood, and you are asking me a question. If I tell also, you will not understand. Because to understand, you need a certain quality of listening. And if you don't have the quality of listening, your guru, who is such a great person, has told you have not understood. So how will my words understand? You will increase your listening, then you will understand even if I don't say.
Now you get further confused.
Puna vyakya prakatita parabrahma tattvam vivanam. Dakshinamurti says, the guru mauna vyakya through silence conveys to the student. Through silence he conveys, because the student knows how to listen. Listen carefully. Right, so the guru says, Janaka says, you are asking me, how do I know your guru has sent you? Right, the guru has told you or not understood. If I tell, how will you understand? So anyway you come. The dance party was nearly over. So therefore, Janaka the king takes him and says, no problem, tomorrow we'll start our teaching. You come, he says, come there and make some. Gives him one of the best of rooms in the palace, his own room, Janaka's own room he gives, right? Now this monk is very disturbed, right? He comes and says, same room, and the room is so beautiful, beautiful bed, furniture is wonderful, because the king's room, he says, sleep here, and tomorrow we'll have a dialogue, and therefore Janaka goes, and this man is seated, in the bed there, wandering from an ashram, I'm put in a palace, and my guru says, Janaka will complete the teaching. I can't understand what is the teaching. And the guru is one who's watching dances. Right? He gets confused, and next day, when Janaka comes to his room, knocks the room, opens the room, this man opens the room, he says, did you sleep well? Janaka first asks this sadhu, he says, no, I could not sleep at all. Janaka says, why you could not sleep? To which he says, how can I sleep there? There is a knife hanging in Janaka's bed. There was a knife which was hanging by a very thin thread. So when he has to lie down on the bed, the knife was hanging right towards his throat. Right towards his throat it was hanging, thin thread. And therefore, death is hanging right, and how do you expect me to sleep? Janaka says, the room is wonderful. He says, but the knife is hanging. And why is that in your room you have a knife which is hanging? Death which is hanging. And to which Janaka starts his upadesha without even telling his upadesha. That's why parents should teach their children without even telling their teacher. That's the whole art of teaching. You should never tell, okay, class, shuru hua. No. So he says, beautifully, Janaka says, every time I remind myself when I lie down, death is hanging in a very thin thread, because life is, a sword was hanging in a thin thread. I remind myself that death is hanging. Any time I can die. Because jatasya hi dhruva mrityuhu. He quotes in the Bhagavad Gita, jatasya hi dhruva mrityuhu. That which is born will definitely die. I remind myself that it can happen any moment, and therefore I never take life for granted. What a great teaching. He says, since death can happen any moment, I never take life for granted. And Janaka so beautifully gives the scope of his teaching without even telling he is teaching. He says, you are able to see life hanging as death, whereas I am able to see every person in this world, when the girls are dancing, when others are watching, when people are walking, I can see all of them as death, 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 death. For you, you have to see a knife hanging. For me, when I look at everyone, I see even if the girls are dancing, I see death can happen any moment. I don't need a knife there, but any moment death can happen, for death and life are not opposed to each other. Death and life are the two sides of the same coin. The two sides of the same coin is death, life and death. A great message from the Bhagavad Gita. Dehinosmin yatha dehe kaumaram yauvanam vara tatha dehantara praptihi dhiras tatra na mukhyati. A wise person na mukhyati, he is never deluded. When Arjuna is afraid, oh, he may die, Lord Krishna in the second chapter of the Sankhya Yoga, he says, Dehinosmin yatha dehe kaumaram. Right? Don't think death happens at the end of life, says Lord Krishna. Death is happening every moment.